it's Tanya, and I thought I would do a bit of swatching of these Prima Pastel Metallic accents that I showed you in a very recent haul. And I've got a little homemade watercolor art journal here, and I'm just going to do the whole put the black lines across, because then you check the opacity, although I think that was probably, actually it was serendipitous that I did that. I wouldn't have discovered what I discovered if I hadn't done that, but you will see in a moment. But yeah, I mean, these watercolors probably wouldn't have needed the black, because they are, I think, probably, as you can see, they're kind of translucent. But the magic's going to appear soon. Anyway, I'm unaware of this magical moment as I proceed to... Oh, paint. There we go. That's a really, really beautiful color. My golly, it's a gorgeous color. And yeah, I've sped this up only twice because... Well, actually, I don't know why I've only sped it up twice because... Ah, and this is where I'm starting to suspect something. Can you see what's going on that black line there? I don't know if you can, actually, but yeah, just wait. And we're trying this lovely looking color, and now we're seeing something, and now we're thinking, okay, I need black paper. So I'm on the hunt for black paper right now. And I eventually found some, but I cut out that very long wait. And I'm checking, and oh my golly gosh, look at that. Isn't that just beautiful? Now, it doesn't say anywhere on this packaging that these colors just come alive on dark paper. Are we supposed to know that by the fact that it's metallic? Am I just being really, really daft, and I should have known, and this isn't the most amazing discovery I've ever discovered in my entire life? I don't know. Because I checked before I started this video, I went onto the Prima website to see if I could get any, and look at that blue! Oh! The birds are singing right now! And that green! I mean, just, anyway. So yeah, I went onto the website to see if I could find out any information about these semi-watercolor paints, and I couldn't find any. It just really doesn't say anything. In fact, I couldn't even find these on the Prima website. I found the other ones, but, you know, the first lot, but not these ones. So I don't know if I should have automatically known that this is the magic of these paints, but I'm going to go with the fact that I have made this joyous discovery, and I am sharing it with you. And yeah, I will say the one thing is that this pink and this purple are almost identical on the black, as you can see there. And yeah, it is showing up slightly more intense on the video than it does in reality, but it still looks gorgeous. It still has that's more to real life that. But now I want to know, do you get black watercolor paper? Maybe that's why they're semi watercolors, because you can use them on non-watercolor paper and they will work. So yeah, I thought I'd better swatch them anyway, because I had started that. And yeah, the more pigmented ones obviously are going to show up better on our normal white watercolor paper, as you can see there, and this green is just stunning. They're really pretty colors. It's the paler ones that obviously are not going to show up like they do on the black. But I was so super stoked to find this out, and now I'm going to have to, and you can see the glimmer in the my water. Yeah, so now I'm now showing you, and now I'm thinking, okay, do these then do the same thing on black? Because these are the first ones that they brought out. So we're going to test those as well. Because now I'm just on a complete kick. And I am just over the moon, as you may have gathered. So yeah, what I'm going to actually do is speed this up a little bit. Otherwise, we're going to be here forever. Okay, so now I'm going to whiz through these colors at hyper speed. And there are some similar ones. I'm going to indicate them once I'm done. But look at that blue. Oh. Yeah, so does one get black watercolor paper? I don't think so. But this is quite a heavyweight black cardstock, and it seems to be doing very well. Even the black shows up on it. Look at that. Ah. Happy heart. So yeah, now I'm just indicating which of the colors are similar between the two palettes, but there are enough there is enough difference between them to warrant needing both, in my humble opinion. And oh, I've gone looking to find this also takes a bit of time, so yeah, we can just stare at the gorgeousness for a while. But yeah, I swatched the first lot in, there we go, in that watercolor journal, and they do show up much more on white than the second palette. I'm just doing it again, and I'm not sure why, because I did it the first time. And but yeah, so there we go. If that is something that really appeals to you about doing paintings on black paper, I think Dina Wakely or Diane Reevely has a black journal. Boggles the mind. Anyway, thanks for watching. Bye-bye.